Hello all. Today I will talk about the advanced searching in PubMed. And when we click in advanced link, then we get back this advanced searching border. And basically this allows us to be able to bold up some queries using particular keywords. Here is the specification of the keywords. The specification of keywords. It allows you to search in specific fields or tags for particular journal articles using a particular queries or keywords. For example, here we have such a tags here called data publication. Data publication. So if you want to search a particular paper, you previously knew the date of publication of this paper, then you can specify your searching by this tags, date publication, for this particular paper. Another tag called author, specify your searching if you know the author name. Another tag is title and abstract, which is used frequently. And basically, it's searching the keywords in the title and abstracts of all the journal. Another option is the title tags, which searching in the title of all journals. So this is how to specify the searching by pulling the search in a specific tags. So let's use it. If you want to say, to find papers that study mutation in the FOXP2 gene related to speech development disorder, particularly. So firstly, for understanding how these tags work, I will pull the keywords separately, then join them in only one pooled search, and compare the results that gained in every searching methodology. I will use here three keywords: mutation is the first, and speech development, and FOXP2 separately. Then combine these keywords in one search and compare the result. Here is mutation and search. Here is searching only mutation. And this is the result that I gained from this search for only mutation for all fields. I have 1,118,247 results or hit. Then again, I want to repeat this step for speech disorder. And then get search. Here you see that the speech disorder is appeared here in query box. And then I search for it without any specification here. That means the speech disorder is being searched in all field. Again, I search for FOXP2, and here is the result 637. And here is the representation of where FOXP2, the keyword I used, being appeared in the paper. Is it in the title or in the body of paper? Then I search, I repeat this searching using tabs. Yeah, I using tags. For FOXP2, I use title and abstract. For mutation, and then choose from here and Boolean terms, and this will appear here in your query box. Also, I use title abstract for speech disorder. And again, I use and here is the Boolean term and appear with speech disorder, specifically for title and abstract. And again, I use title abstract for FOXP2. And then get and here is the query box content. And then get search. And here is the result. It's only 7 result that have been displayed in the title and abstract of the paper. Then again, I will repeat the advanced searching for the three keywords without any specification. Here is just I want to use a Boolean term without any specification or tags here. I want to search the Boolean three terms or three keywords without using fields here, just searching for all fields. Then mutation. And then and speech disorder, and then and finally Fox B2, and then and here is the query box without any specification or text, and then get search. And here is the results with Boolean search without any specification of the text. From here, you can see that there are very interesting changes here. When you use mutation only, you get 1,118,247 hits, and you use and when you use speech disorder, you get this huge number, and Fox P2 it's 637. And when you get search for only Boolean three keywords, mutation, speech disorder, and Fox P2, you get 127. And when you concentrate your speech, your search in the title and abstract for the keywords, then you get only 7 hits. Thank you for today, and see you tomorrow in next video.